Everybody loves big carp and they're impressive to look at and often difficult to catch as well, but there's lots of things you can do to help your chances improve when it comes to catching the biggest fish. And over the years, I've been lucky to catch one or two of them as well. So what we're going to take a look at now is a few things that you can implement into your fishing that will help you improve catching those big ones. Doing your research might sound like a tiny piece of the jigsaw, but let me tell you, it's one of the most important parts about targeting a big carp, because the more you get to know about that fish, the easier it's going to be to catch it. So get into the habit of trying to find out everything you can about its previous catch data, sort of the swims that it's been caught from, the times of the day it's been caught from, and the areas of the lake as well. You know, and the best example I can give to you here is, it's a piece of water in France that's called the Orient, which is about 6,000 acres. And there used to be a big fish in there that was called the bulldozer, and it only ever got caught from an area called Gerardot Bay, which is about 100 acres in size. So if you wanted to target that fish, then you could rule out 5,900 acres of the water. So it obviously made the task a lot easier. And it's the same in England as well. You know, you'll often find that certain big fish will frequent certain areas regularly at certain times of the year. And you know, if you get into the habit of looking through Facebook at previous catch data, asking anglers about when they caught them and what times of the day. You know, if you're an overnight angler, then there's no point targeting a fish that tends to get caught during the day. And you know, I've been an angler that fishes short sessions in England for many years until recent times. A good example I can give from my own fishing is a fish called Arnie that I caught from Manton Old Lake in North Lincolnshire. At the time I was working in an office, it was when I used to put carp talk together, and that fish tended to get caught about 1 o'clock in the afternoon from all of the catch data that I got. And obviously 1 o'clock in the afternoon is when you needed to be in an office. So I managed to get myself with flexi hours, and I actually made two visits a day to that lake. So I was doing an overnighter and pulling off 7 o'clock in the morning, going to work, doing a few hours in the office, and then driving back to the lake to be on the bank during those couple of hours when I thought it was a good chance of me catching it. And I'd also found out that that fish, for some reason, it was a weird one, it didn't tend to get caught much in the springtime. It tended to get caught more in the summer times. And it's more than just a coincidence that when I eventually caught that fish, it was in the afternoon at about 1 o'clock in the middle of July. So, you know, from that point of view, it was a really important key element about catching that fish. So the moral of the story then is to do your research and get to know as much information as you can about the fish that you're targeting. Now, big carp tend to fight completely different to small fish. Generally speaking, they're very slow and plodding and just go wherever they want to. So it makes sense to use really strong tackle. And you know, when I'm fishing in the UK, I've got absolutely no problems with using 15-pound mono, 18-pound mono or above if I'm fishing near to weed or snags, because I want to make sure that when I do hook into one of these biggins, I've got a better chance of landing it. Now, you see a lot of people these days who prefer to fish for bites, which is completely different to fishing for big fish. When it comes to big fish, you need to use good, strong, reliable tackle. So size 2 hooks, size 4 hooks, no problem for me. I want to make sure that when I do eventually hook one of those big ones, I've got a better chance of landing it, because you've got to remember that sometimes you spend weeks, months, I've actually spent years chasing big fish. So it's of massive importance to make sure that when you do eventually get it on the end of the line, you've got a better chance of landing it. You might sacrifice a few bites by doing that, but trust me, it makes complete sense. And I think the best example I can give here is when I eventually caught Eric's column from Rainbow Lake over in France, which is the biggest carp in the lake at the time. It was 86.5 pounds. And that particular week, I didn't catch many fish. And when I did hook into to Eric's, it managed to get into lots of different snags, lots of sunken trees. I knew it was a big fish that I was attached to, but the gear didn't let me down. And that's the most important point when it comes to tackle, is that you're using good strong tackle and it's not going to let you down at the most important moment. The next topic I want to talk about is tactics, because there's lots of things we can do on this side which will influence your chances of catching the biggest of fish. It's slightly related to the first topic we talked about, which was research, because the more you know about your target fish, the more you can adjust your tactics to suit. You know, if you're fishing for a carp that's really rounded and large, and that kind of fish is going to feed completely different to one that's long and slender. You know, the up end a little bit different, so you can change the length of hook link that you use. Perhaps use a longer hook link for a larger rounded fish and a shorter one for a long and slender fish. But it's not just on the hook link side of things. You can also maybe use a larger hook bait, an 18 miller, 20 miller, 22 mil bait. They do sound large to a lot of English guys, but believe me, big carp do feed on big items, and I've actually caught carp on hook baits that are over 40 mil. You can also do things like put more bait out, the old baiting pyramid that Rod Hutchinson talked about many years ago, whereby the more bait you put out, the more carp you get to attract to the table, in which case the smaller fish come in and have a feed, they then get full up and move off and leave the biggest fish in the area, and obviously there's a better chance of you then hooking those fish. You know, a couple of years ago, I caught some really big fish by putting lots of bait out, but it's all down to the venue that you're fishing. You might need to chop and change your tactics. Last year I fished a lake in Yateley where I started off with the big hook baits, and eventually I realised they weren't working for me, and I had to revert to using the baiting pyramid and putting out lots of small items of food out there, and eventually it caught me the biggest fish. So, you know, do chop and change, but again, it's about tactics. They definitely works when it comes to big carp. You get the right tactics, you've definitely got a better chance of catching them. So the next bit needs a bit of explaining, because you might have heard people talk about big fish baits. Do they exist? Don't they exist? Well, when I was a young carp angler getting into the industry, I believed that they didn't exist. I couldn't understand how a big fish could tell the difference between that bait and that bait. And it needs some explaining, because as I've progressed throughout my career and I've had it explained to me, and I've seen it in motion as well, big fish can definitely tell the difference between some baits. Now, it's more to do with taste preferences. As something gets older, whether it's an adult in the humans or a child, as you get older, your taste preferences change. When you're a young kid, you like sweet, savory type flavors, but as you get older, you want something a little bit stronger. And it's the same with all walks of life, whether it's calves and cows, kittens and cats, puppies and dogs, and it's the same with fish. As fish get older, they want something a little bit different. And we know through research and lots of field testing over the years that certain ingredients stimulate big, older fish a lot more than the younger fish. That's not to say that you won't catch all sizes of fish on some baits. It's just that big carp, generally speaking, they're the wilier carp, they've been around a lot, they've been caught quite a lot, they're the hardest ones to trip up. But if you've got something new to the game, a new ingredient, something that's gonna make them a little bit inquisitive about what it is, well, if you've got that in your bait, then there's a better chance that you've got of tripping that fish up. And we've seen lots of examples of this over the years with lots of different bait companies. You know, when I worked at Carp Talk many years ago, we saw phases of some baits catching more fish than others. And a couple of years later, somebody came out with another bait and that bait did exactly the same. And we're not talking about baits that's just catching big fish. We're talking about baits that catch the really hard to catch fish. There's certain ingredients in them that definitely trips up some of those hard to catch fish. So the purpose of what I'm trying to say here now is, get yourself into the habit of using some of the top bait companies that's out there, because the top bait companies, you might pay a little bit extra for the bait, but you can guarantee that the field testing's been done and the baits that you're going to get on the shelf, they're the ones that have been tested, they've got a proven track record, and you've got a better chance of catching the big fish with them. So the final piece of the jigsaw, and that is the big carp mindset. And it takes time to get this, because you have to endure lots of blank periods when you're targeting a particular fish. Maybe there's those moments that your friends just caught it and you haven't. What do? Do you keep going, or do you pack up and change late? Well, in my mind, you keep going, you keep following it through. It's having that big carp tunnel vision. You've set your target, you want to catch it. And eventually when you do catch it, it gives you a massive buzz. But what is a big carp? Well, to lots of people, it's the largest carp in a local park lake, a 20 pounder, maybe a 30 pounder. To some people, it's a 50 or a 60. It's down to you to decide what's a big carp. But all I can say is that when you do catch them big ones, it's a proper buzz. And I hope that the little tips that we've talked about today will give you a better chance of catching the ones that's on your mind.